What if I told you that you can make AI create photos of you doing absolutely anything, like this or this or even this? In this video, I'll show you exactly step by step on how you can generate AI images of yourself. You don't need any technical skills or coding. All you need to do is watch till the end. With that, let's make some AI magic happen. Alright, step number one is to collect and zip your images. Make sure you collect 20 to 30 high quality images of yourself with different poses, different background and lighting, etc. So the more varieties we have, the better the model will perform. I have 25 different images of mine. These are not the ideal images that you would want to continue with, but we are using it anyway. So put all your images into a folder and right click the folder, go to compress, zip file. Alright, so we have created the zip file of the folder which contains all our images. Okay, so this was step number one. This is your golden key to generating AI images of yourself, and we'll be using it in step number two. So step number two is go to replicate.com and sign in. Once you are signed in to replicate.com, you will see this page. And now it's time to go to the description of this video. You will find a URL. Click there. That will take you to the Flux training environment. When you open the link, you will see this page. Scroll down a little. Now on this destination, we will create a new model. So click the drop down. Click create new model. Give it some name. I will call it Sohail Persona 3. I want it to be private, so let's select this option. Scroll down further. It is asking for input images. This is where we will provide the zip file that contains all our images. Simply click here, select the folder, scroll down a little more, and this is very important. This option, it is asking you for a trigger word. So this trigger word, whatever I choose, it will be linked to my images. So it will somehow tell the model that you have to generate image of Sohail, for example. Make sure when selecting this word, it is not a generic word such as chair or dog, etc., because it will confuse the model. So in our case, I will call it Sohailpreneur. That might sound weird, but bear with me. Alright, so these are only three things that we need to configure. There are a bunch of other options that we don't need to set up. Alright, now scroll to the very bottom of this page and click create training. Alright, the training process has been started. So we have to wait around 20 to 25 minutes before we see the magic. So it will also cost you around $1 for the training. So make sure you go to your profile and add your billing method before you create the training process. Alright, the training has been completed and now we can test the model. So let's try to generate our very first image. Simply click Run Trained Model. There you go. In the prompt area, we will define what kind of image we want and this model will generate it instantly within few seconds. Before that, let me show you how you can go from dashboard to this area. So when you are on replicate.com dashboard, you can see these models. Just click it. On this page, you will find the model that you have created. Just click it. There you go. We have come back to the same area. Okay, let's write our very first prompt. I'm going to say a superhero version of Sohailpreneur standing on top of skyscraper at sunset. So it is very important to mention the trigger word that you have created during the training. Okay, so let's see what it come up with. Simply click run. It might take few seconds before it gives you the output. There you go. This is perfect. I like it. Let's try some other prompt. Let's say a superhero version of Sohailpreneur standing close to camera with a smile. Click run. Alright, this is perfect. Much better than before. So it has captured my face very accurately, including my beard, my eyes. So that's interesting actually. Well, let me tell you further how you can improve this prompt, because I'm not creative enough to provide a detailed prompt to generate something very realistic. So we will use ChatGPT to enhance our prompt, which will result in enhancing the output image after all. Anyway, let's go to ChatGPT, explore GPTs, search for Flux Lora. You'll find a custom GPT called Flux Lora Prompter. Let's select this one. Start chat. Simply paste the prompt and say, enhance this for me. Okay, let's copy this entire prompt. Paste it here. Click run. Perfect. This is amazing. Now watch this, how easily I can, you know, change the colors, the clothing, etc. Let's say wearing white hat and red t-shirt. Let's click run. Perfect, look at this. This makes perfect sense for a YouTube thumbnail. If I edit it a little more, instead of capturing random images of myself to put it on YouTube thumbnails, etc., I can use this probably. Now you can take the same concept for maybe one of your product. You can capture different images of your product from different angles, train this Flux model on that, and then generate any kind of image of that product. And then you can use it for marketing. You can post it on social media, etc. So you saw how easy it is to train an image model on your images, your product images, or anything else. Now you can just sit and brainstorm lots of use cases for it and then use it accordingly. So there are lots of other informative videos on AI on my channel. Make sure to check them out and see you in the next one.